y'all, what is up and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I decided I wanted to kick off a new series. There's gonna be, I think, one or two that just are dispersed throughout the month. Just kind of keep things consistent as much as I can for as long as I can do the series. And so the series I wanna kick off today is the College Young Adult Budget Advice Series. We all know the struggles of being a young adult. You're either in school or you're working, or there's just so many different routes you can go through, and you're really, this is the time where you're testing yourself and testing what all you actually really learned and what all you know and how to actually live everyday life. But it does come with a lot of struggles and its own pitfalls and stuff like that that we're just all trying to learn and get back up on our feet and grow from. So with this series, I'll be posting it around mid-month sometime. And yeah, just look out for one of these videos. We're gonna cover a wide variety of topics. Today's focus in the series is budgeting food specifically. So groceries, how can I properly do a grocery budget? How much am I gonna spend on food? How do I make a plan for grocery lists and not go crazy with it? Before we hop on in, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up if this is helpful for you in any way. Comment below any of your tips that you have or you've figured out so we can all help each other out in this community. And don't forget to hit the subscribe and the post bell notifications so you are notified when I upload so you can keep up with this series. And with all that being said, let's go ahead and hop on into the video. So I have three main points that we are gonna cover in this, but before I get into those, the first two things I wanna cover is you need to first, don't set the budget immediately, if this makes sense. So first thing, don't set your budget immediately, especially if you have no idea how much you are realistically going to spend. Now, what I mean by this is, obviously, when you move out on your own, you don't think about all the little things that you had access to in your parents' home, all the cleaning supplies, the little tidbits here and there that you just didn't think of and you probably didn't bring with you. So it's not just food that you're having to consider, but it's also general groceries that you're now gonna have to figure out. And to top it all off, you don't know necessarily how much you're gonna spend on food because you don't necessarily, you might have some of like the spices and stuff like that already accessible to you at your parents' house, whereas now you don't have that. It's okay for your first shopping trip that is gonna be quite pricey because you're getting those little things and it's near impossible to budget on that. And you don't realistically know how much you're gonna spend on food in general. So it's okay to kind of splurge and see where you're at. And then from there realize, okay, we can cut these expenses off because I already have these spices, now I have these cleaning supplies for now, and now I can focus roughly on my budget for food. I think that was the biggest lesson, especially coming to South Africa, was I had still had quite a bit of the little things that were accessible to me. Thank you, Crystal and the Earlies, for that. But I went from dollars to rand. So stuff that I knew would be a certain amount in dollars, I had no idea for rands. So I knew a good budget for dollars, but not for rands. And so the hard thing was to figure out, okay, I still need to get some of these little things, but how do I convert from dollars to rands? How do I budget this properly? So just take the time you need to like work that out, work out realistically how much it's okay to spend. The second thing is, like I said, the first shopping trip, it's okay if it's gonna be a lot more. It's gonna be a lot more than you think. But after that, like, don't have a heart attack. Don't picture that price as your price continuing on. You're gonna have to pay for some of the other stuff, but it's not all at once like you will in your first shopping trip. So like I said, cut off those extra expenses that like the spices and stuff that you're not gonna need for months, and then you can get a rough idea of how much you probably are gonna be spending. My first tip for young adult college budgeting is start a meal plan. Now, I know this is a bit tricky for some because I'm also talking with people who are in a university that require you to have a meal plan. So food's pretty much already provided for you, especially if you are living on campus. So this isn't necessarily a tip for you until you start cooking your own food and stuff and are paying for actual groceries besides snacks and stuff. But if you are like me, going to a really small school that they don't provide food or meal plans or anything like that, it's kind of on you. And even if you're not in school and you are a young adult working and living on your own, then this is the tip for you. Start a meal plan. And everyone kind of gets the idea when I say meal plan that you have to plan out every single day's meals. And some people do need that, but what I've learned the best thing to do is to not do it so specifically. You know, your moods change, your cravings change. Some days you want Indian, some days you want Mexican, some days you want Italian. And it's just frustrating because you've planned for an Indian dish when you want pasta. And it's just frustrating because you're like, well, I have this, like, this is what I've planned for. So my tip is when you budget, you go look and count. Let's say I used to shop a month at a time, and I would literally look and see how many dinners I'd have to plan out. And if I made plans with friends, then that's less groceries I have to buy. Obviously, I have to budget in that I'm going out to eat. But I looked, I said, okay, I need 30 dinners that I have to plan for. So let me write out a list of 30 different dinner ideas. And obviously, eating by myself, I could make a whole shepherd's pie and that would last me 4 dinners or 2 dinners and 2 lunches. And so that's where you kind of figure out, okay, if I make a whole lasagna pan, that's going to last me probably a week. And planning out, okay, is this going to cover all my dinners? Am I going to take this for lunch and eat for dinner? And work out how many number of dinners. Write a list. Do not assign it to a specific day. Just figure out those specific meals. And then from there, figure out and write a grocery list of what all you need to cover those meals. Now that it's more Grant and I focused meals, I have to go shopping every 2 weeks realistically because this child eats me out of house and home. No, I'm kidding. But it's a lot more food to deal with, and obviously not all of it's gonna stay, and it's just easier for us to plan out 2 weeks at a time rather than the month that I planned out. But that is my next tip with it that falls into that line is shop in bulk. So that's my tip number 2, shop in bulk. I used to shop, like I said, a month at a time. Now I have to shop 2 weeks at a time. And the tip with this, the trick with this is you actually spend less. When I used to go shopping every single week, I would spend between 400 and 600 Rand on a really good day. And I was like, why am I spending so much? So that equals between 1200 and 1400 Rand a month. And I'm like, this is so much, like I need to cut back. And so one of my friends did the tip of making that meal plan, making it very general, and just shopping for that stuff all at once. And when I did this, it took off so much money. I went down to, I think, a thousand Rand, instead of paying the 200 or 400 extra on that. And the realization is every time I would go shopping, I would get the stuff I need, but then I'd want like a treat. I'd want to get some chocolate, or I'd want to get a certain kind of chips, or I'd buy this or that, whatever. And it would just add up. And slowly over time, that's what the extra expenses were. Now, if you're going once a month, you do include that stuff in your budget, but you're not doing it, you're not including it every single week, if that makes sense. You're not splurging a little bit 4 times in a month. It's now just the once a month. And if you really need to go to shop again, then it's only probably 100 Rand trip, if that makes sense, to get what you need. But you're not having that extra little spending spree that you had every single week. Now you just have it in the month. So everything's there. It becomes a lot cheaper just to shop in bulk. And it's easy just to, if you run out of something, then you just go to the shop. And like I said, you're spending less than 100 Rand, or around 100 Rand. Especially if you do decide to get yourself sweets at that point. But it just makes life a lot easier just to go shop in bulk, get exactly what you need, and then you're not tempted every single week to get something else for you. My last thing, my number three point, is what I'm labeling the don't forgets. So these are things do not forget when you go shopping for. The first thing is do not forget to include eating out. So when you make your plan, include times that you want to eat out. Realistically, we all want to eat out and have a good takeaway. We want to go get McDonald's or KFC or go out for a nice dinner with friends. And that's okay. Just budget for it. So you have 25 meals for the month. And then say, okay, 5 of them I'm setting aside for takeaways. So you have that freedom to work with and you have it planned in your budget so you don't feel guilty about it. The second don't forget is don't forget snacks. When you go shopping, plan for snacks for the whole month. You don't want to go and get exactly what you need for the month and then realize I don't have anything else to eat other than those meals. It's realistic to have snacks. So when you go shopping, when you make your grocery list, include snacks on there and make sure it's snacks that will realistically last you a month. I think for me, when I looked at a month, 4 bags of chips would last me the month. And it would go between packing in my lunches to me just snacking on them randomly. But they were just things that you just can't forget. Do not forget to put those on your list. Those are my 3 main things, is create a meal plan, but it doesn't have to be specific. Create a general meal plan. Number 2 is shop in bulk. And number 3, do not forget those 2 things when you are budgeting and shopping and stuff. And I hope you guys enjoyed these tips. I hope they are helpful for you. I hope going forward that, you know, budgeting becomes a lot easier. It's become a lot easier by trial and error for me. So I hope just these few tips are very helpful for you. Be on the lookout. Remember, once a month, this series will be coming up on a different topic. I think next couple of ones, we'll be talking about how do we include clothes shopping, how do we include, you know, the coffee runs, stuff like that. So if you are looking forward to that, do not forget to give it a thumbs up. If I forgot any tips or you found any tips that would better what I have, comment them down below. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on your post bell notifications so you're notified and can keep up with the series that I am doing. But with all that being said, I hope you have an amazing day and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.